Last year was one of the most successful years we've had in organization history. We had an organization best winning streak, and I think it was like 39, 40 games. I think we moved up something like 12 guys as well. I don't know the numbers exactly, but as far as things like that go, it was the best we've ever done. Obviously, our goal is to get our guys to where they want to be. And last year, we felt we did a really good job at that as far as getting kids moved up to tier two while still being able to kind of win a lot of games. And we, like I said, we went on a stretch where it almost felt like we couldn't lose if we wanted to. And I think that's just a testament to the hard work that's put in when recruiting the players and also the work that we do when they get here. I still don't like talking about it. I haven't watched the game since. It's still a sore spot because that's our goal every year is to win that. Hats off to Rochester, they had a phenomenal group, but when we got there, we felt like we were exactly where we were supposed to be, and we ended up exactly where we were supposed to end up. Fell one game short, and I don't think that takes anything away from the group last year, because outside of that one game, it's the most successful group we've ever had. To me, it's a group that has big shoes to fill, but it's a group that's capable of doing it. Obviously, we don't expect to win 40 games in a row every year. That's not realistic. Would we like to? Absolutely. But we don't expect to do that. The goals don't change. We have the same goals, regardless of who's coming back, regardless of who's coming in. The goals are the same every year, and it's to win our regular season division, win our division in the playoffs, and win the Fraser Cup.
Everybody, welcome back inside the Armadillo Deck Rink here in Sauk Rapids, Minnesota, as it is playoff season yet again, as Granite City and Willmar will face off here in the opening round of the West Division playoffs. The redemption tour here for Granite City, as their season was heartbreakingly ended early last season as they could not finish that historical run, losing in the Fraser Cup Championship game. Same team, same mentality, same coaching staff here this season, as Granite City vows that they will get back to the St. Louis area and battle for their fourth national championship in franchise history.
Ready to go? Okay, let's get after right away. We good on these?
Yes.
Okay, we've been to Hunted all year, right? Target's been on our back all goddamn year. Let's go hunt tonight. Let's get after it. Let's get on the bodies. Forwards establish the forecheck, 2-3 pinch. Two guys in hard, make life difficult on their forwards and their D, okay? Other than that, let's have some fun. D, let's play fast, get it up the rink. Patient in the neutral zone, and let's capitalize on our opportunities.
This is a public service announcement sponsored by Just Blaze and the good folks at Rockefeller Records.
Fellow Americans, it is with the utmost pride and sincerity that I present this recording as a living testament and recollection of history in the making during our generation.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Ho.
Bielenberg walks it in. Bielenberg right side. In front. He scores! Tucker Sky! And the Jacks are on the board! 1-0. Good guys! Mortensen flips one. Far side. In front. They score! Knocked down that wall! Nick Partland. He makes it 2-0. Good guys! They beat it to him. Kennett sees a window, centering pass, puck is loose, right side, they score! Nick Portland again! A power play goal! And it's 4-1! Back up to Greeley. Greeley with some space, quick shot, he scores! Tipped in front from Kennett! Greeley fired inside from the blue line. Kennett, right place, right time. A chance for Mortensen. Mortensen, he scores! Captain, my captain, Kyle Mortensen. To head back, quick drive, that one, he scores! Kennett sniped one right in front.
Trying to get some change, and I do it twice, ain't no sense to me. Hey, I get in those ones it's difficult to kind of keep a cool head and not be a moron. I get it. But I'm, for the most part, proud of how we handled ourselves in the third. We preach all year long, you win with class, you lose with class. That's just something that's never really been in Wilbur's DNA, okay? Now you've got the easy one. The first one's the easy one. Ending a team season is never easy, no matter who you play, who it is. So, be ready to strap it up tomorrow night, because I don't want to come in here on Sunday. Let's end this tomorrow night. Most? Oh,
yeah, that's just one tick on the tally, right? We have a couple more to get through, but tomorrow's the most important one. We've got to end a team season, and they're going to make you earn it. Whether they're doing it the right way or the wrong way, you're going to have to show up with your untucked, and you're going to have to work tomorrow, right? There's another W on the line, and like DJ said, I want to play Fortnite on Sunday.
And one thing, I usually don't say much, but Kyle, the way you guys handled yourself tonight, not going to say the team we played, because it might be on video, but that was a show, and I would rather not even have a team than see that. And this one, too, is for Brad. You know, he's sitting at home. He's missing out on this, so let's take care of this for Willie, and it's just a nice win, boys.
Road playoff game, trying to end somebody's season tonight. Everybody lock in right now. Let's get pucks all the way in deep. Good first five of this period, okay? Good first five, get on the bodies early. You guys know what you need to do. You just gotta go out and do it. Okay, DP, let's move the puck. We'll have the low option for you. PK, ton of communication. Even keel, head screwed on straight. Do your job. There's bigger goals for us to achieve. Their only goal is to beat us. We've got more than they've got. So, bring it right from the start.
Hey, it's like we talked about in Mason City. It's us versus them in a room, and it's whoever fights to win and survive. And it's going to be the fucking group tonight, all right? We're going out there. We're going to end a team season, and it starts with the first five, all right? Everybody come together. Keep your heads. This ref knows about all the shit that happened last night, so he's going to be looking out for it tonight, all right? All the extra shit behind the play, leave it behind. We focus on what's in front of us, and we can take this game. Let's go.
Centers don't want to work in front of the net. That's the problem. You guys gotta work. They're not gonna roll over and die. You go out there and coast around for 20 minutes. Yeah, we get chances. No fucking hitting anybody. They score goals because centers and D don't want to work. Why is Buckingham in front of the net by himself? Whose guy is that? That's a center. So it's either a center or a D. Goals. Guy skates right around you, shoots, and you look right at the puck. And then he picks up the puck and buries. You don't get a puck in deep, they bury. You got 40 minutes. Start working. They're not going to roll over and die. They're not going to. If you want to play tomorrow, continue to play like you did that first period. But if you want to get this job done, you got to sack up and work. The effort that first 20 wasn't the effort that you displayed the last 60 minutes. Figure it out.
You got what you deserved. You fell asleep for 5 minutes in that period. The first 15, yeah, they were all right. I mean, they weren't great. It'd be nice if we could score a power play goal. But you fall asleep for 5 minutes this time of year when you fall asleep. That's what happens. I mean, That's what it's expected. You take a nap, it gets shoved down your throat. You can still win this game, no doubt in my mind. But it's going to take everybody, and it's got to start from fucking puck drop here. So let's fucking go to work and claw our way back. Let's go. Give us that effort in the third period, you'll win the game. And you gave us the effort and you won the game. You stuck with it, battled through adversity. Damn it, if we don't got to spot them too and make it tough. But nobody said any step of this was going to be easy. Tonight wasn't easy. Next weekend sure is going to be easy. But you're capable of great things. It takes every one of you. So we had some guys step up tonight. I'm proud of you. Good game.
Yeah, I mean, that's fucking playoff hockey, baby. I think it took me this long to kind of come unglued on you guys, and you deserved it, but you needed it, right?
And you responded.
And you responded. You woke up. So I'm proud of you for that. And I'm thank you that we got the job done tonight. We get the day off tomorrow. Make sure you're doing the right things, yes. Fellas. You got to do the right things from here on out, right? We said it in our the guys that weren't in the meeting. From here on out, it's got to be you got to buckle down. Put the away the extracurriculars, whatever you're doing away from the rink, it's got to be focusing on the task at hand right now. All right, I picked this one up. We're gonna start a little new thing, right? This is series one, right? So it's a little game puck. We're gonna keep this thing around, right? Just to remind us how far we're going, right? So we're keeping this bad girl around, keep it in the room. We'll collect one the entire way. So what we got, two, like five, six more to collect. Take the five games at St. Louis, and then two more next weekend. We'll keep these things around, right, boys? Johnny?
That's what you're chasing?
Oh, yeah.
And one other thing? Don't eat!
Yeah, practice leading into playoffs is huge for us, and it should be kind of like that muscle memory. We shouldn't have to go too deep into practices, but at the end of the day, you know, passes need to be tape to tape, it needs to be crisp, it needs to be fast, it needs to flow, and guys need to battle hard Monday through Thursday. That way they're prepared mentally and physically for the task at hand, which is to win a playoff series.
That's how this should be. Get on the guy, make contact, get a stick, get him a shot.
shot. Don't let him beat you to the net. Right?
Obviously, it's a three-game series, and you might play three games in 3 days. Well, you practice, you know, 4 days in a row, so we need to stay sharp and stay on top of each other and battle hard. That way, those 4 days in a row put together, when it comes down to the Friday, Saturday, potentially Sunday matchups, we've already did that. We got through the hard stuff during the week, so we just need to go out and, you know, stick to our game plan. And outwork our opponent.
Okay, next drill will be one-on-one. All it's gonna be, let's say you are logo area, defensive guy. Let's go on your knees. You'll have a coach in either corner with the puck. We're going both ends same time, okay? It's just whistle one-on-one. Defensive guy has to pick up a stick, a body, whatever. On the offensive guy, we need to get better at picking guys up and staying between them and our goaltender. Okay? So it's one on one, whistle, take off, and go. Okay?
Yeah, this weekend will be the toughest weekend we've had all year. I mean, the last couple games we played against Alex in the regular season were tough because they added a bunch of good hockey players. I mean, all the credit to them. They brought in guys who are some of them overqualified to be in our league and some of them who really excel in our league. And we welcome the challenge during the week. I mean, this time of year is more game prep and kind of cleaning things up and making sure our guys are healthy. So. We've watched film twice already this week. We'll watch it again tomorrow before the game. And then it's all, the coaching staff is all just concerned that our guys are prepared and we won't leave any stone unturned and make sure we're ready to go for this weekend, which will be probably our toughest test all year to date.
Every time I played Alex, it's not really going to go out there and score a whole bunch. Just got to go out there, do what I'm told, block shots, play good D zone, just get pucks in deep, hit. Just try and get under their skin a little bit so our top guys can go out there and score while they're a little tired or a little mad at me because I wear a cage and I chirp them. But hey, it gets under their skin and I think we just need to come out with a little piss and vinegar in our system and show them what's up.
Alex has been a good team since they picked up all those NA guys, so it's going to be a team we have to play hard every shift against. We're going to need every one of our guys to be going hard and doing the right things to be able to beat them just as we did the other weekend.
I mean, Alex is a good team. They've been kind of a thorn in our side all year. Can't take them lightly. I mean, but we know how to beat them. We've done it before, and I'm not really worried. I know we have the group, like we have what it takes to beat them and move on to the Frazier. So yeah, I mean, just gotta take it one game at a time and we'll beat these guys for sure.
Ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's get after it right away here. If we make them play our brand of hockey, which is the right brand of hockey, they're gonna struggle. But if you let them get away with playing the easy way, long stretch passes, not defending very much, it's gonna be a pretty good game. Patient in the neutral zone, keep them in front of you, know what you're doing and who you're responsible for on faceoffs. Other than that, you've done it already. No reason we can't do it again. A lot of pucks on net, right? We know this guy, he's gonna f***ing flop all over the place. Bear down, get one in on him early, and we'll just go after. But we're right where we wanna be, okay? So, let's have some fun.
down low. Whitmore has a window. Near side, top shot, he scores!
Hey, other than the penalties, I thought it was a pretty good period. Thought we did a good job in the neutral zone. I think we can do a better job of getting pucks all the way in. We did give up a few odd mans where they're two-on-ones or three-on-twos from our offensive blue line in, where we're pitching and not getting anything and they're just going around us. Just stay out of the fucking box. I told you, if you make it easy on them, it'll be a long night. Five-on-three is easy. What happens? They score. That's what happens this time of year. But all in all, I think our game outlasts theirs tonight. So continue to fucking believe in what we're doing and believe in each other.
It's strictly skill. See, he wasn't gonna call that right away either.
Flynn plays catch with DeBrito. Back to O'Flynn. O'Flynn with a drive. He scores! Power play for O'Flynn. Quickly, just 14 seconds into the 5-on-3, and the Blizzard have taken the lead. Still in control for DeBrito. Granholz. Granholz far side. O'Flynn with a drive. Right side, they score again! Another power play goal. And it's three straight for Alexandria. Halfway through this contest, it's 3-1. Serpent back up top, trying to center this one. Right side, puck is loose. He scores! McPartland out in front. Short-handed, Kenny all alone. Kenny drives, he scores!
I thought for the first half of that period, we were kind of behind the eight ball. Like we're kind of running around, not really doing what we're supposed to be doing, and not really hitting anybody. And then last half, I thought we took it to them, other than giving up a breakaway. I thought we took it to them for the most part. We're getting pucks in on net. We're making plays from below the goal line. You're not out of this game yet, but you have to go after these for 20 straight minutes. Right from the jump, two guys in hard on the forecheck. Make them earn every inch of ice and just funnel pucks to the net. Rebounds are there for you. Get to the net. Go score the ugly ones, but you're more than capable of coming back in this game.
Do your job. Do your job for 20 minutes, right? Know what you're doing in the D zone. Don't let somebody else do your job for you, all right? Got to have a third guy high here, or to run to the 2-3 pinch, can't give up any more odd mans, right? 20 minutes of hockey here, boys. You got to bear down, bite down, lean on sticks. It's not over till it's over. You got 20 minutes of work. You play buzzer to buzzer here. Let's go.
Let's go.
Skye out in front, right side, top shot, he hits the crossbar. Below the near circle, at second drive, puck is still loose, battling for it, right side, puck in the crease, where is it? And finally, a whistle blown.
Oh, you motherfucker, it's a fight.
Trying to send this one all the way down, no luck. Final 10 seconds left. Big victory here for the Alexandria Blizzard as they take game one of the West Division Finals. A huge victory for Jeff Krause and his squad. These two teams will square off tomorrow night in Alexandria. 7-10 puck drop.
I told you before the game, you make it easy on them, they'll beat you. They went 3-for-5 on the power play and scored a breakaway goal. Right? Like, and we can say what we want about the refereeing and all the yeah, was he sure, he was. They all are. But it's our job to kill the penalties when we put ourselves in those positions. 5-on-5, you win the game 2-0. They scored 3 power play goals and a shorthanded goal. They can't touch you 5-on-5. They can touch you in a power play game. So, could we have scored 5 or 4 in that game very easily? A couple pipes, him sitting on pucks, whatever it may be. Yeah, we could have done that real easy. But, now we go up and we have a must-win game in a hostile environment. No reason we don't win it and then come back here and win it and send them back. So, most.
It's pretty clear cut and dry what the job is tomorrow, right? Get the out of here, short-term memory, and we get back at it tomorrow, right? Let's go, okay?
Nothing to lose tomorrow, right? It's a tough one for them. It's an easy one for us. Let's have it tomorrow, right?
And let's call spade a spade. We get to go either way. You know that. I don't have to tell you that.
I know you know that. But I don't want them to get to go with you because they don't deserve it.
Nope.
Eight guys who played up until what, January in the NA? They don't deserve to go. You do. You earn the right to go, win or lose. But they fucking deserve to go. And let's beat them tomorrow night. We'll come back, reset, and beat them again. Okay? Nothing to lose tonight, right? Backs against the wall. Let's get after it right away. Pressure on them. Okay. First 5 minutes, road playoff game. Let's have a good first five. Are we good on these?
Yep.
Okay. Start with that rim here on D zone draws. Just draw it up quick so we can make sure everybody's on the same page. Okay. We're lined up here. D center, wing, D wing. We win it back here. Their inside D is gonna come and pinch it off. You have to be under him. These guys are doing the same thing. He's low, short, out at your D, out the middle. Hammer it hard, okay? Worst case scenario, we'll beat out an icing here, or it'll get here, we'll chop it out. He'll be here, he'll be here. Questions there? And shoot the puck, put it on him, even from bad angles, put it on his feet. Other than that, let's go get a job done here and play tomorrow.
That's going to do it. The Blizzard are heading to the Fraser Cup Championship as they smother Kausch in the corner.
Once we got down by three, we said, let's play, is what it was. I'm proud of the effort in the third. They real easily tied that game up. They're carrying nets off the ice, all shit, like whatever. Guess you get to play in St. Louis, who's in your bracket.
These motherfuckers.
Yep. Rather beat them there than here. Yeah, we wanted to win. Yeah, it sucks. But luckily you guys earned your way in with what you've done up until this point. Let's not squander the opportunity. We've won it as a wild card before. No reason we can't do it again. It's going to fucking everybody. It's what, 4 games in 5 days or whatever. So strap it on. We still got a lot of hockey left to play. When we do our jobs down there, there's no reason we can't hoist a trophy. Close?
Yeah, I mean, that effort in the third period, last 10 minutes, I mean, that's the shit that you fucking bring from puck drop, right? You know, guys that were here last year, you know, Deej and I talking in between first and second period, it's that first period, that first 20 minutes is what it felt like in the final last year. It was just dead. Fucking stagnant, dead. And then it took a couple for us to fuck up, but we just need to fucking smoke and fucking go when we get down there, right? It's going to be a long day of travel. But we need to do the things that we know how to do.
right? And I think we got away from our game plan that made us successful the last time we played these guys in the regular season. We got a three rip, right? We got to fucking run around, a little squirmish out there. That's the type of game that they want to beat you. Fucking here. We're still in it. We're still alive, right? It's playoffs. It's a new season. Anything can happen. You've just seen it, right? But we still have an opportunity to fucking ring. Fucking nail fucking brains. Nail that fucking brains. You don't have to be the fucking best team. You have to be the tightest team. You have to be the ones willing to do shit that other people aren't willing to do. So, nail that in your fucking brain, because we're not fucking dead. We're not fucking over. The season still fucking rides. Nail it in your fucking brain. Think about it. Manifest it. Come together. We're still here, fellas. We're still fucking here. I'm fucking still here. Deed is still here. Everybody's fucking here. Alright? Till they tell us that we can't play anymore and our season's over, we're still here, right?
Now it's everybody's got to be going the same. Going to come back. You guys knew you were in right away. I don't want to use it as an excuse. You think they won the Stanley Cup out there? And we get to play again. New time. Let's go. Hold your heads up.
It kind of sums up what playoff hockey is about. Alex, we ran into a team that, I mean, has the closest thing to depth that we have. And they're a team that punishes you for the mistakes you make. And at this time of year, the mistakes you make amplify and they get bigger, even if they're small ones. So they did a great job at taking the mistakes we made and turning them into opportunities for themselves. Apart from that, I think it put everything into perspective for our group, and that if we don't leave everything out on the ice and we take for granted how well we've done coming up to that point, it's not going to end the way we want it to. So.
I know this is the f***ing 18th time we've played them in 3 weeks, but we need to f***ing be even keeled. Let us deal with the refs. There's two of them out there. They should be seeing everything. They're going to miss a couple, whatever. But let's go f***ing out there. Let's have another really good 20. Let's f***ing pop the first one in here.
Let's go, Red.
Thank you.
stolen by Whitmore. Down to Granholz on the backhand, he scores! Josiah Granholz gets redemption and puts the Blizzard on top 1-0.
And what set up that entire play, Mark? A turnover by Granite City right out in front. Got that two chances to score. Made a nice effort on the first one, but yeah, you can't give a high-powered offense like Alexandria those tough chances, those easy chances in front. But a great
by Lukaszek. Blizzard with a three-on-one opportunity the other way. Delzer trying to get back. It's McIntyre. McIntyre still with it. Backhand. They score! A backhand centering pass to McIntyre. That was Kingery on the far post, and the Blizzard lead 2-0.
What are we going to do? We want to pack it in and call it a season, or no, let's claw our way back into that. But you gave up three really good scoring chances. They scored on two. We just haven't had that many good looks because I think we're panicking a little still. But go out and send it for 20 minutes. Goal differential and all the matters still in pool play. So you have to continue to play and go after them. Okay? Get up on your toes on the forecheck. Run into somebody. Create turnovers. D, take a deep breath. Let's play fast. Let's get the puck up the ring. Other than that, man, go pop the first one in, and then the second one's going to come shortly thereafter. Most?
I mean, they score that second one because we're just four guys up the rink and nobody's covering, right? We have to be a little bit more aware of what's going on the ice, right? D, you got to be better making outlet passes, but that goes hand in hand with forwards. When D get the possession, we can't have two guys on the other side of the red line. Like, we have to come up the rink together. We can't stretch out the guys. That's not our style of game. We can't play their style of game and expect to win. We have to play our style of game, right? Get back to it. You got 20 minutes. Empty the tank, all right? Do what it takes. You have to play whistle to whistle, buzzer to buzzer this period. You look like a bunch of donkeys if you keep running your mouth and doing the stupid because you're down two rip to a team that's had your number the last couple weeks. Shut the up. Go play hockey for 20 minutes. Good things will happen. Figure it out. Let's go.
In front, Granite City just can't corral it. Drive, big rebound given up. Far side, Conrad save. Second try in front, they score. Granite City knocks down that mountain and finally gets one past Kausch. Time and you get the bonus points if you win. Chance in front, they score. Top shelf, Hadland. A big oops in front and he finished strong. Excellent scoring opportunity and Ryan Hadland. The vet puts his team right back on top by two, and there is your Blizzard answer.
Delzer throws it in front, Kausch pounces on it, and the horn blows, so the Blizzard do take game two here against the Lumberjacks, and will punch their ticket to championship weekend.
One and you're in tomorrow. So, once we leave here, this one goes away. Play your cards right, you get them again on Sunday. Okay? We owe those guys a lot better effort. I thought the effort was there. They make us, our mistakes hurt. Okay? We give up four quality chances, three of them going. What happens this time? I'm not mad with our effort and how hard we played. We just got to clean up a handful of things, and we win that game. So, almost.
It comes down to little shit, fellas. It's playoff hockey. It's not the dainty fucking backhand sauces, little plays to the middle, fucking poke and goes. It's owning the lines and winning the fundamental part of hockey. And that's easy to do. It's just whether or not you guys decide you want to do it, alright? It's clear cut and dry. It's clear cut and dry. You either live to fight another day or we pack it in and this is the last time this group's together. Want it to be over? Pack it in.
Play it for your lives.
You want to play for something bigger? Bring it tomorrow. Do what you got to do to prepare for tomorrow.
You can still win the whole thing. Let's be clear. That's why this one stays here. Once you leave this place, we prepare for tomorrow. Okay? You can still win this. Okay? But it's a mindset you have to believe. We have to be locked in from here on out. So, whatever you will need to do to get over it and here, get over it, and we're moving on. So, punch box.
Yeah, first game was a lot of what we did in the division final. I thought we were a little better as far as things we had to do in order to be successful, but I still think we made the same mistakes we did the weekend before, and that's kind of why the result was what it was. It was no lack of effort. I mean, we played our tails off, but Alex seemed to be rolling, and it felt a lot like the weekend before. But it put us in a position where we had to win to get in. And at that late in the year, there's nothing more you can ask for other than the opportunity to win a game in order to keep playing.
Hey, at a certain point, I mean, we got to play within our game and our systems, but at a certain point, you throw the X's and O's out the window and you got to outload your opponent. You got to go out there for 60 minutes. You got to outwork these guys. This is a group right now that we need some momentum. We need something to get us going. We need to pop in a couple early, and we need the bench to be buzzing tonight, right? We need to keep going. One isn't going to be enough. Two is not going to be enough. Three is not going to be enough. You pile it on these. We don't lose 50-50 battles. We don't lose races to puck battles on the wall, right? We have to outskate these. You have to outwork them. We got to show that we're in business. Cup contender. And it starts right now. Let's go.
We try to make our 3-foot little chip plays to get out of zones when sometimes you just have to live with getting it out. This time of year, sometimes getting the puck out of the zone is the best play you got, but when we turn the puck over, that's when they're on us, and then we struggle to get out of our own end, where a lot of times we have to win one battle to get it out. We need some guys available, maybe high slot for high tip off the side of the net, whatever, because we're doing a pretty good job. First 15 minutes, we're all over, right? But now we got to get creative with how we're going to score goals. Let's throw it off the end wall. Keep getting it to the net. First one might have to be a grimy one, but don't get, if we go 5, 6, 7 minutes on offense, don't get so zoned in on going forward where you still have to stay above the puck and be responsive.
Get back on the gas pedal, enough of the little 3-4 foot plays. Make it simple on yourself and work from there, all right? Do the stuff that other people don't want to do, and continue to say it because we haven't done it yet. Do the that people don't want to do. We got to be better in our D zone when it comes to that.
Do a good job of getting pucks all the way in, and they'll get tired here. Let's go.
Holds it top of the near circle, flipped in front, quick try, loose puck, right side, under his skates, near side again. They score! Granite City strikes right away in the second period. That puck just floated forever in front, and it gingerly crosses the line. Eventually just pushed back out by Forden. Far side, taken away again, turnover. In front, they score! Kennett, top shelf! And Granite City makes it 2 straight. Over to Skine. Skine with a drive, loose puck in front. Right side with Kennett. That one gets saved again by Forden. Puck is still loose. Nice chances again. In front, they score! Mick Partland, he sends one on net. Forden was turned around. He could not get his spacing back. Here comes Mortensen. Mortensen has Widman. Drops it to Mortensen. Back up top, Bielenberg. Howarth in front. Top shelf. He scores. A rocket from Bielenberg Howarth. And Granite City makes it 4 straight.
Obviously, great period. You're up 4-0. But I feel like every time we turn the puck over, it's an on-man rush. Or could be. Like, literally every single time. Where, like, we gave up a couple breakaways. We try and dangle somebody and give it and lose it, and then it's 3-on-2. Your only jobs this period are to defend well, get pucks in deep, and forecheck your ass. We don't need any more goals. Granted, we're going to score some more, but you have to be on the defensive side of pucks. You cannot get beat up the ice. Lock it the in defensively for 20 minutes, and we get to play more.
okay? That's all I ask you. Play defense first. Don't cheat. Zero cheating. Because poke and goals here aren't what we need. We need you to go through guys to get pucks out and to get pucks in. Do the hard this period. Be in shot lanes. Take a hit to make a play. But just do your job for 20 minutes, most.
Just do it the right way this period, fellas, right? Just like DJ said, just do it the right way. Don't cut corners here. Do the simple. Make it a boring period on ourselves, right? Because a boring period's a good period for our hockey group, right? They got 20 minutes of life left in them, but we're going to end their f***ing season, so don't do anything dumb. Stay out of the f***ing. Just stay out of the f***ing, right? Stay the f*** away from them. Just stay out of the f***ing. Get away from it. And they're going to f***ing. They'll go after you, all right? So f***ing just let it go, skate away, and f***ing we play tomorrow.
Don't get f***ing sniff here. Come on, let's 20 go. Minutes.
There's to Langer. Langer with a drive, nice save. Right side, they score. Big rebound in front, and Granite City pounds that one through. 6-0 score. Have a tough road ahead. As there are some good teams, but Granite City does do it. As they win this one 6-1, the Texas Brahmas, their season has come to an abrupt end.
Season's over.
Oh yeah!
Oh yeah! Get the only negative thing out of the way, that last goal sucks. Because it was a dumpster fire shift with 30 seconds. I know, grand scheme of things, it doesn't really matter, but it would have been nice for your goaltender. You get to play another game, and good job today. We need to improve defensively tomorrow. Have to. You're not going to get to go out and do whatever you want tomorrow. So, we have to play together defensively, but I'm proud of you back against the wall and you respond.
Yeah, I mean, just got to sharpen up on the little fellas. It's going to take everybody. It's going to be a lot tougher of a road than that one was, that's for sure. We know who our eyes are set on right now. Right? Like, obviously, we have to wait and see who we're playing tomorrow and the time or whatever. But in the grand scheme of things, we know where our eyes are set on. So keep that in the back of your mind. Got another puck. Thank you, Rob. Add this to the collection.
Coach of the Granite City Lumberjacks, DJ Bold. Heck of a win there. A 6-1 dominant win against the Texas Brahmas. Talk about what you saw from your guys.
Yeah, I thought we played well. I mean, right, you kind of expect them to respond. I told you yesterday I was excited to see the effort we came out with, and I thought they came out with exactly what I expected them to. Played a lot of offense, and it got squirrely at times, but all in all, happy with the overall effort.
Definitely. Let's talk about that a little more, that back-against-the-wall mentality. Both teams were facing elimination today, and you guys come out on top, but just talk about how excited you are for your guys and that mentality that you guys brought today.
Yeah, I mean, what more can you ask for? You control your own destiny. We win, we get to keep playing. I mean, at this time of year, if you would have told me we'd have that chance, I'd take it every time.
You talked there a little bit about destiny. Right now, we don't know yet the destiny of who you guys will face tomorrow, but it'll be the top seed of Pool B. Three teams, we see two of us behind us. One of them's done with Oregon, but what are you guys thinking? What's the mentality, obviously, again, for tomorrow?
Yeah, we played two of them at the showcase in Northeast and Oregon, so we're somewhat familiar, but we'll do our homework. We'll make sure the boys are ready, and from there, I mean, on the Saturday games, it's anybody's game, so we're just excited to be a part of it.
Semifinal Saturday, we're looking forward to good things from you guys. Appreciate it.
Absolutely, I appreciate it. take all day to play, man. I'm itching to get on the bench. You're right where you're supposed to be. This is right where we expected to be, too. The first game went exactly how we wanted it to go. So, let's f***ing skate right from the start here, show up on time, get on the bodies early, and make life difficult for them. Ozone draws. If you get the lineup like this for them, they're trying to win it back here. He's going around the net. He's coming like hash mark area. So we are going to let our winger jump this D. Inside D is responsible here. Man on, and we've got a safety valve still. Okay? So we're just getting up on it to get a little more pressure. If they get it up here, that's fine. You don't have to pinch. Frankly, probably don't want you to, but stay out, play the rush. Should be no more than a 2-on-2. Other than that, power play, move the puck. They love the backside guy on their power play, so forward's got a second help. Other than that, let's have some fun.
Do your job tonight. This is a team that's capable of doing unbelievable things when our back's against the wall. And our back's against the wall right now because it's win or go home. So, you know, up until this point, we've done everything as best we could. And it's up to you guys right now, right? The rest of the next two games are in your hands, and why not go and take it? You guys are capable of doing something special. We got to take care of business tonight, obviously, but put yourself in a position to be in the big dance, all right? Go out there, work for 60. 21 is one. Everybody together. Do your job, know your role, do what you're fucking good at and what you're capable of doing, and good things are going to happen. Stay out of the box, and these guys, they don't like to be hit, they don't like to be pressured. So get in their fucking face, shove it right in their fucking ass, and let's go fucking win a hockey game. Bro.
The window had it for a chance. Puck is still loose. Shot taken. French. Nice save. Second try. Another beautiful save. Wiped off. Great chances there for Granite City. French all over it. Robinson back down low, quick try, that one just goes up and over and more.
Hey, I think that was one of the best periods I've seen our group with back pressure. Forwards, that was excellent the way we're getting back. But the thing you got to think of right now, though, is we can't have two, three guys hunting the puck back, right? You have to have one guy, two guys hunt the puck, and the third guy, you have to be finding where their extra guys are. Because if we do turn that puck over and it's just laying there, we don't need everybody zoned in on it, and now they just pull it out of a pile and it's a little odd man, right? Hey, Jadel, you got buried in the corner. Did that feel good at all? No, it hurt. Robbie gave us a look of what a forecheck looks like. He chipped it in and he hammered their D and he got them clean. You got to get your money's worth on this forecheck because they're not going to want to touch the puck. He's second guessing touching that puck in the corner next time it gets chipped in because he got buried. It's just the nature of the game, right? Go in there, forecheck hard, get on the goddamn bodies. D, you got to utilize the glass if you got nothing. Forwards, they're pinching down on the wall, so you either got to reverse pinch them. We have to have really good center support coming through, and we just got to lean on the stick and get pucks out, right? Getting the puck out is not a bad option. You just live to fight another day. Now we get back up on the forecheck and we regroup, right? Be stronger at the lines. Make them retrieve pucks. Make their D work to get the puck out of their own end. Great period. Let's have another good 20.
For some space. Good drive. Puck is loose. Right side. Top shelf. They score. Power play goal for the Big Horns. Chemino, top circle. Flipped away. Blocker save. Puck still loose. Battling for it. They score. Puck was loose in front. Brower finishes. And we're tied at one. A couple lucky bounces for each team. Has some help. Wraparound chance. Does he get one? No. That was kicked away. Granite City, top of the circle. Schemenauer's got wheels in front. He shoots, he scores! Schemenauer, top shelf, bar down! And Granite City has taken a lead. It's 2-1.
Just like last night, just like yesterday. Fuck, man. You got one job here. Play well defensively, be on top of pucks, but sit back and act like that's going to win us this game. Go after these f***ers. Get the puck in deep. We around a little in the neutral zone that period, right? We're f***ing stabbing at pucks and poking and going. You drive through bodies. You f***ing win battles. That's it. F*** battles, but don't poke at pucks and hope and pray. That doesn't work in the game of hockey. You go make sure that if you want the puck, you go get it. You want it in, you go get it. You want it out, you go get it. But do your job. Shifts have to be shorter. Skying, length, shorter, please. But go get the job done. Go after these and we get to play another day.
Defend hard, retrieve pucks hard, be available. Keep your foot on the gas pedal. I think I'm down to about 4.5 D right now. So forwards, you have to hold the lines. Stop turning over pucks. It's playoff hockey. It's an elimination game. Play the simple game. Play the easy game, and we're going to win this, right? Let's go out. You got 20 minutes of work. 20 minutes of work. We regroup and go at it again tomorrow. All right, let's go. Get the job done.
Piled on. Bottom of the circle. Right side shot. Take it. He scores. The equalizer. Right side, one timer from Chaminade. He feeds this one down low. Wrap around chance, puck is loose, battling for it. Still loose down in front, they score! Loose puck in front! Jacks hammer it home! They reclaim the lead! 3-2! Left side, Huglin top of the circle! He scores! Top shelf, Huglin! Oh, an uncharacteristic move! He beats French! And the Jacks do make it two straight!
They line up straight across here. Right four and two. They throw a guy here. We still got to get out here. D can come in here. Winger can come in here. If it's a winger, you're out two and then out here. It's just you're killing a penalty with five guys. You got to sag and help. You have to be in shot lane. You've got a minute 27.
Watch the back door play.
Yes. Hey, that's on a swivel.
Hey, same thing here. Hey, same thing here. 50-50 pucks. We have the pressure all along the wall. 50-50s, right? You gotta bear down on the fucking full fucking square hockey.
Opportunity just missed. All the way out, 7 seconds left now. Granite City, they're headed back to the Fraser Cup Championship. They'll have a date with their division rival, the Alexandria Blizzard, tomorrow at 3 o'clock. What a fantastic semifinal game. Hats off to the Helena Bighorns. What an outing.
You do it!
I'm gonna tell you one thing for free. You're the last team Alex wanted to play tomorrow. And it's gonna be pretty sick when we carry a trophy out and they've got all these NA guys and all the. Very proud of the third period. Very, very proud. Because we finally just fucked and buckled down the hatches and said, we're gonna go do it the right way. We gave up one early or whatever, but after that, we buckled down the hatches and just went to work. And you believe in the process. You got to do it 60 more minutes, man. Tomorrow's gonna be fun. Yeah. This went exactly how we wanted it to. And goddamn it, if we don't love losing the first game we play to come back and win the trophy. We've done it before. There ain't no we can't do it again. I brought everybody in because we wouldn't be here without everybody. We got guys dinged up and all the so some of you guys may get to play tomorrow, and I want to make sure that we're all on the same page. Most?
Yeah, I mean, you can't really top that effort in the third period. Granted, that equalizer, but you guys played simple hockey. Now, tomorrow's a game of simple hockey. Simple playoff hockey. Hard hockey. And there were some guys that showed up in tonight's game that did their job. They knew their role. They buzzed around. They took bodies. They did the shit that other guys don't want to do, and that's what it's going to take tomorrow. All right, you got 60 minutes and your season's over. 60 minutes, that's a cakewalk. Get the home, get to the hotel, Do what you got to do to prepare mentally, physically, whatever you need, because tomorrow it's all hands on deck. We thing and we swing it right in their faces, right? Be ready to go tomorrow. Here's one more. One more. Waiting for that last one. Waiting for that last one, all right? Last one completes it.
Vold, after a huge win just seconds ago, you guys are going back to the Fraser Cup for the second consecutive year. Show a little emotion for us.
Oh, man, I can't stop smiling. We're so excited. I mean, hats off to Helena. What a good year they had. They've got a few younger kids that are pretty impressive players, and it's an organization that's ran well. But I'm proud of how my guys performed, and we got the job done. Yeah.
Let's dive into that game a little deeper. It was just back and forth pretty much all night. They had the empty net or at the end of the game. You guys held on to just secure things and move on and just celebrate. And just talk about what you took away from that game.
Yeah, I mean, a big message we've sent all week is just do what it takes. It takes doing what other people don't want to do to take the trophy home with you. And it's something we've preached about since the same game last year that we lost. It's going to be pretty cool to get a chance to win it again.
Yeah, and it's going to be even cooler against a rival, somebody that you saw, somebody that handed you that wild card spot to come here to the Fraser Cup. You're going to take on a Western Conference foe. I'm going to call it a rivalry, big brother, little brother matchup of the Alexandria Blizzard. But you don't got to do too much game notes. You guys know each other. You see each other every other week, it seems like. But just talk about the mentality and what you expect for tomorrow.
You couldn't write it up any better, right? It's what we wanted, frankly, right? The team that knocked us out in our division finals, we get a chance to go at them again. If I could have wrote it down for you and handed it to you, this is how it would have went.
You know what? We're going to turn it into a movie. 3HL movie. Appreciate your time, brother. Good luck tomorrow.
Absolutely. Appreciate it. Thank you.
But I felt like that game was the first time that we truly experienced what it meant to have our backs against the walls. No question you had to win to get in. And I felt like it was the first time all year that we felt that and responded to it. Guys like Reed Hannes and Sam Brennan and guys who, let's say, may have been role players prior really kind of stepped up and were fantastic. I mean, we had guys blocking shots, taking hits to make plays. We had everybody buy into the group goals. As one unit, and you could tell with how we played and how bad we wanted it that we weren't going to take no for an answer.
Yeah, again, you know, back against the wall, it's win or go home, an elimination game, and I think guys really started to see the light at the end of the tunnel, and everyone was on board. I mean, I think that was one of the best hockey games and complete hockey games that we've played. I think our group played a full 200-foot game, and it was a really good test for our guys to show that they can win it all, because we went up against a tough hockey team. They played physical, they played fast, they played hard, and our guys responded well. I thought our back pressure in that game was the difference, our forwards getting back and helping our D out, and we were able to transition pucks well. But at the end of the day, you know, it was a tight hockey game, you know, through the full 60. They never gave up. They gave us a really good battle, but our guys just stuck with the game plan and were able to battle back and get the job done.
Hey, are you good if I throw a couple things on top of your gray sheet
Inside winners jump them, but at the end of the day, this game's not about X's and O's. You played these guys enough times, you know the ins and outs, so do they. This game's about who wants it more, who's willing to do what it takes, and who's willing to sacrifice for the betterment of the group, okay? Go out and do your job for 60 minutes, play hard, play together, stay out of the BS, let's go win a hockey game here, but I love you, I'm proud of you. From here on out, it doesn't matter, nothing's gonna change that. But let's go to war for each other and with each other.
20 is one tonight, Red. We've come a long way since September. We brought our fucking horses in, and these are the ones that we want to ride with. You don't skate around these guys, you skate right fucking through them tonight, and it's going to take every last one of you. Empty the goddamn tank. You got 60 minutes. 60 fucking minutes of work. So go empty the fucking tank to take what's ours. Fucking out there for 60 minutes. Starts one shift at a time, and everybody rallies. Bench, create our own energy, create our own destiny. Let's fucking go take this thing home, baby. Yeah!
Game, and there's a lot of them for both programs. We're underway. Granite City in red, Alexandria in white. Frazier Cup, Nadong out in front, right side. Robinson with a drive, that one just goes high. Rebound, far side again. Centering pass, what a stop! For the Blizzard, looking for some spacing. They're going to get it. Top of the circle, top jump, they score! Bouncing puck! Start putting skates on. Here's another chance, far side. Top of the circle, they score! McIntyre, top shelf! At the center ice area, Sendin, he brings it in. Sendin, look at this entry. Sendin tries, he scores! Top shelf! Walks to the front of the net, right side, puck is loose, defensive help, right side, they score! There we go! Granite City finds a way! Johnson in front, house got...
Hey, now we got nothing to lose. Down by two, you've been down by two before, but it's just another piece of adversity for us to deal with. You don't lie down, you go hard till the last buzzer. I don't give a shit what happens. You can still win this game. I don't want any doubters on the bench. You doubt we can win this, stay in here. Because when you force these guys to defend, they suck. But when we turn pucks over and let them walk it into the zone, they're pretty good. Yeah, so are we when we teams let us do that. Get on bodies a little more, okay? But stay out of the we don't need all the extra BS, because in order for us to come back and win this, we got to stay out of the box.
Nothing we've never been through before, fellas, all right? Like he said, we just have to keep emotional control here, all right? We got a little too high, we got a little bit too away from our game, the cross checks, the sticking, all the extra shit
shit, holding guys up, stuff like that. Just focus on our group here. Focus on the red jerseys, all right, fellas? We got to focus on each other. This is f***ing... Relax. Relax, all right? We're going to have to work for our f***ing goals. We are. But where was the back pressure from the other night tonight? We need f***ing back pressure coming up the ice forwards, right? We need to be a little bit harder so our D can stay up and keep the gaps a little bit tighter. F***ing turn pucks over and it's boom. Now we go the other way, all right? Come together here, all right? That one goal that we popped in there is huge. We just got to get through this kill, and now we get back to work, right? Emotional control here. Everybody is one. Let's go, boys.
Hey, you score their next one.
Yo, let's go.
Charlie Larson, left faceoff, Dada Shotta. Pad saved there by Lahette, but they couldn't clear it. Hedlund with a one-timer rebound. They score! Matt McIntyre buries the rebound, and the Blizzard do capitalize and take a 4-1 lead. Granite City has that shot in on net. Kausch gave up a rebound. They score! Tucker Skyim gets the goal for the Lumberjacks, and they have cut the lead in half. Pure hustle there.
Matt, I can't wait to see you again. I can't describe how that puck made it from where it did and through the bodies that it did, and it just kisses the inside post.
Well, it was the rebound he gave up. That was the problem on that. And
I just didn't make the right play on it. Yeah, he put his panel on over the blocker.
And Sky makes some pay. It off to Granholz. Demars with the shot. He scores! Hayden Demars! A wrist shot off of Lahette. And the Blizzard go up 5-2 late here in the second.
What did I just say? Got to block shots to save opportunities. Ryan Lahette, phenomenal second period. No help there in front. Schemenauer was just out of position as that one buckled off his shoulder. Can't block shots from that far out. That's what's going to happen. Look at that space.
Yeah, looked like he might have been screened by his defenseman at the last. Goes down, picked up by Delzer. Delzer hands it off to Bieleberg. How did they score? You called it.
I don't hate the spot we're in, to be honest. But it's going to take a hell of a lot to come back. But I think we can do it. I don't have a doubt in my mind. Here's the deal. Every fucking goal we've scored, it's because we're going hard to the net. Skymer's goal. He sheerly panics because he sees Skymer's barreling it on. Get the puck on net and go to the fucking net. You make the goalie beat you. If you make him stop it, I don't think he's got it. You make him stop it, he's not going to stop them all. So get the goddamn thing on net. Get your asses to the net. D, you get the puck. Forward, you better be flying at the net. Because he's going to give up a rebound and we're going to bang it in. But you got to believe for 20 minutes here. That's all I'm asking. Believe for 20 and let's fucking leave it all out there.
20 minutes of hockey, fellas. 20 minutes of hockey. Right? Empty the fucking tank. Empty the goddamn tank, play for each other, and get the job done. We got to go to the net. We have to go what's made us successful. That's going to the net and putting pucks on the net. Stop trying to make the extra pass. Put the puck on net. Make sure somebody's hungry to go to the net and pick up the loose change. But we got to shoot the pill. We got to put rubber on. We have to take care of our defensive zone, all right? Forwards got to get back hard. We transition with each other, and we come up the ice. Right? It's got to be a hard 20. It's got to be a hard 20. Empty the f***ing tank. Untuck it. Play with your heart. Leave it all out there. Right? It's up to you guys. It's up to you guys. Who wants it? I think right now, I think they already think they have it. Go shock them. Go shock them and f***ing take this thing. Let's go.
Let's f***ing go here.
Schemenauer from the right point. Tipped in front, they score! Granite City comes through and pulls within a goal. Your Sam Brennan from the point. Brennan with the shot. Blocker save. Loose in the slot. It's kept in by Robinson. A turnaround shot. He scores! The Lumberjacks tie it up with 2:47 to go.
Unbelievable. You just got to believe, Mark. That is exactly what I got in front. Bielenberg looking to make it two in a row. Right side. He scores! Carson Van Sylen! Granite City completes the comeback. They lead 6-5 with 9.2 to go.
With 3 seconds left, 2 seconds left.
Granite City has climbed the mountain! A four-time NA3HL national champion! And one of the most historic comebacks in Fraser Cup history! 6-5, Granite City backs against the wall in the universe! They come through! A four-time champion!
Congratulations and introducing the 2023 Fraser Cup champions, the Granite City Lumberjacks.
Baby!
got exactly what you deserve.
Oh yeah.
And that's why I'm fired up for it, because you deserved every bit of that. Yeah, I don't have a ton to say other than let's have a time.
Yeah!
And all the hard that you guys didn't want to do throughout the year, it all pays off, right? Like I said at the beginning of this game, September, we picked our horses. Yeah, we added a couple guys. We added a couple guys late where needed, but picked our horses in September, and we rode with you guys, and you guys rode with us.
Right.
And all the early mornings, the 7-foot snow driving through all the. All that shit is worth it now. This is a memory that no one will ever be able to take away from you, and you'll remember this team and these guys for the rest of your life. I still talk to I've got 1,000 notifications from the guys that I won with because they're so pumped up for you guys. We talk every day. We got our grouper going, but never let anybody take this away from you. You guys deserve this. You earned it, and holy what a goddamn movie that game was. And when this documentary comes out, you're gonna need a f-ing bucket and a mop. Hey, I f-ing love you all. I'm proud. Turn that off.
So, like we said, every time we've been the sixth seed, what's happened?
Loops in the bag. The writing was on the f***ing wall.
Yep. Every time we've been the sixth seed, we've won this f***er, or the eighth seed, or whatever, the last wild card seed. We've done it.
F***ing lose to the f***ing team.
Yep. You guys are something else. It was just a f***ing amazing. I'm so proud of you guys for all the work you put in.
Oh, here we go.
Matt couldn't come today. He wants to say something.
Hey, I'm here with Matthew. Matthew, you want to say something to the boys? Say something. Don't be afraid. Swear. I don't care.
Say f***.
Fuck you all. Yeah!
Okay, now I hope I can get through this. We had Brad go through his deal, came back, he was here. I had to leave on
Tuesday,
and my mom got in the hospice, lasted a day and a half, and I got to hop on a plane this morning and come here. And experienced probably the best comeback and best hockey game the Lumberjacks have ever had. And you guys did it. And you're great. You'll live with this forever. And just proud of y'all. You didn't give up. I mean, it looked bleak there for a minute or two. And you guys stuck with it. And for that, I think somehow we're going to do it one more time, and that's going to be donate!
I've been doing this since I was 18 years old. This day has eluded me since I was 18 years old to call a championship for the team I love more than anything in the f***ing world, kids included. Thank you for today. You guys are f***ing heroes for the rest of your life. I f***ing appreciate and love every single time.
Damn!
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 Damn! Damn!
Damn!
Hey, 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 hey
Yeah, I mean, it's doesn't feel real. I mean, I just got back a couple days ago, and just, I mean, I'm literally holding the Fraser Cup, what I've been wanting for all 3 years of my junior career. I mean, this is what I came here for, and it just, it doesn't feel real. It doesn't feel like this is here, but it is, and it's the best feeling I could have asked for. The best way to go out. I couldn't be more happy.
Everyone had faith that we were still going to get it done. Coaches basically said, get one quick, and they're going to piss down their leg, and they did. They folded, and they didn't know what to do, and we just responded in the third period and came out and wanted it more at the end of the day. I think that's all it was.
You can't really put it into words. I mean, when VZ scored that goal with 9 seconds left, and you kind of knew that we secured the game. There's no better feeling in the entire world. Just being out there in the last 9 seconds and being able to, you know, celebrate with my brothers, and there's nothing better. I would not have wanted it any other way.
Yeah, obviously polar opposites. You know, you go from, we had such a good season last year, and you get one game away, and obviously not our best effort. And one of the biggest reasons I came back was to try and win it. And that's the expectation here, is to win a championship. And yeah, it felt so good to get it done for the organization, the fans, for the boys.
I got a little nervous in the first period after their third one. But we responded quick, and I mean, our older guys and the guys that had already been to the Fraser Cup championship game itself had kind of kept everybody on the same page and kept everybody in the don't give up mindset. And I mean, that's what we did. We didn't give up.
Yeah, being on the opposite end of things last year, it really hurt. And all I could think about was that game all year this year throughout the season. So it was just a big revenge tour for all of us age out kids.
Yeah, it's definitely one of the first times I've won something huge like this in my career. You know, growing up, I haven't really, you know, won a state tournament or anything to that extent. But, yeah, I mean, this is one of the best feelings of my life.
I mean, that is every junior hockey player's dream, is to, you know, your age out year, you leave your footprint on the organization by going out with the national championship. And it's a very rare thing, and only the special few teams can do it, and I'm very appreciative that I was able to share this one with a great group of vets and an even better group of rookies who we've been able to mentor over the past year. So super special, and just glad I got to do it with the people that were there.
Yeah, I saw it go in, and then we're all freaking out on the bench, and I didn't know how much time was left, so I was trying to calm everyone down, and then I looked up and realized there was only 9 seconds. But yeah, it was wild. I mean, kind of just still really hasn't set in what happened, but it was crazy. Just with these guys, it's definitely a feeling I'll never forget.
Yeah, I won't lie to you, all week I felt like something stupid was going to happen in order to kind of keep it away from us. And I don't know why I felt that way, but I mean, Brad goes down with his health issues. John and Matt have to kind of pick up everything and leave right away. It just felt like, fucking everything was against us at one point. But yeah, I mean, we just kept pushing forward. I mean, that's what you do for your family. It's what you do for the kids, and it makes all the hard days worth it. Because there are some tough ones, but it makes all the things the kids go through, all the things we go through with them, it makes everything worth it. It almost feels like a weight off your shoulders. Because me personally, I felt like I carried around 1,000-pound weight all year in order to get to that game. So it's, it's pretty fucking cool.
One of the craziest finishes to a hockey game I've ever seen. I mean, there's really no words to describe the emotions on the bench, the highs and lows during that third period, but I couldn't believe it. The first thing I did was look up at the clock. I saw 9.2 seconds on the clock, or 9.6, whatever it was, and it was kind of, in our minds, it was like we did it, but we still had 9 seconds. Crazy stuff has happened before, kind of like that comeback that we had there. So we knew that we needed to buckle down for 9 seconds, and Alex called the timeout, and I think that might have been the longest minute and 20 seconds in between the timeout and getting that puck drop that I've ever felt in my life. And that was another situation that as soon as we scored and celebrated, it was calm down, relax, take a deep breath. We still have a job to do. It's a short job, but you got to get it done. Told our center to just bang the puck forward. Don't give him a chance to progress up the ice on us and give him a look. And then Kenny was able to bang one forward to the right side, got into their blue line, got a stick on their defenseman, and kind of iced the game there. And just the emotion of it all. I mean, it's been 6 years since we won it, and losing in the final last year was fucking tough, but I just dropped to my ass and started crying because, I mean, it was about our old twos and the age out guys that felt the hurt and the pain last year, and I just didn't want to go through that again with them, and I just want nothing more than these kids to feel what it feels like to win and how hard it is. And you know, September to the end of March is a long year. It's a lot of hockey. It's a lot of early mornings and extra shit that you don't want to do. But at the end of the day, they're Fraser Cup champions. And I was just so happy and proud of the group and the resilience and the battle and the fight that they showed. And it was all the shit that we've been talking to them about all year. And the fact that they were able to come together and put forth that effort and make the comeback is going to be one of the most historical Fraser Cups for a long time, I think. And I'm just so happy and proud that all those guys in the room got to feel what it felt like to be a champion. And it's a memory that'll last a lifetime. And it doesn't matter if it's a Tier 3 championship or a USHL championship, no one will ever be able to take that away from them. And it's something that's going to live with them forever. So super proud of how our guys responded and got the job done.
One word, describe holding that trophy and winning it.
Priceless.
Unreal.
Champion.
Speechless.
Amazing.
Breathtaking.
Revenge.
Surreal.
Unforgettable.
Incredible.
Accomplished.
Thrilling.
Beautiful.
Redemption.